Hello, HCC family. If you don't already know, my name is Sean and this is my wife, Jess. We are here today to update you on what is happening in Budapest, Hungary.
God has been working in really cool ways. The first thing we want to tell you guys about is the coffee house. It was formerly Riz Kivyo and now we've rebranded to be called Sela. And we just kind of want to start off with sharing in each part of our ministries a struggle that we feel like we've overcome. So at the coffee house, we kind of struggled to know what to own. What we can offer, what to bring to the table, what God wanted us to specifically do there to bring people in and connect with them. And so we did this through a handmade line called Handpicked, and we make jewelry, we make pottery, we do art workshops. And it just gives us the opportunity to have deeper conversation, to tell people about how God relates to creation and share our hearts and our lives and yeah, just get to know people better who we wouldn't normally see buying coffee or within the city.
Also, now people can sit in and enjoy their coffee and enjoy their food. So we've been able to more personally serve and actually like even sit down and enjoy a coffee ourselves
and
with them.
People too, which has been good.
Yeah, that's been phenomenal. Mm-hmm. Also, Friday nights are super fun. The coffee house is open extra late and there's live music. There's a special menu and that just brings so much more connection. And it also feeds into the other area of our ministry, which is the athletics. Mm-hmm. So the struggle here has been finding time to have one-on-ones.
Availability.
So hard
to find availability.
Time. People are so busy. We're busy as well, of course. So finding times that actually work is difficult. But a great solution to this is some training camps that are outside of Budapest, outside the city. That brings more time to have one-on-ones with a lot of athletes and just spare time to make those furthering connections.
Yeah. And yeah, so what's new is that it's coming up to their qualifiers to decide who, what team or what group of people are going to go to the Olympics. And so emotions are running high. The athletes are looking for people to talk to about how they're feeling. Trainings are difficult. And Sean and I, we feel like the Lord's just highlighted us in their minds. And we've had some really amazing opportunities to just kind of be there and listen. And then the next ministry, that would be with the Riverside Young Adults, with the church that we attend in the city. And I think the struggle there that we saw God kind of overcome was just initially when we stepped into a leadership role there, there was a bit of an organization issue. We didn't really know the people at the group. We kind of stepped into it being new at the group as well as being new leaders. But God was so faithful just through like the Bible studies that we were doing, the content that we were kind of presenting to them, and then through like dinners.
So it's very international and it's so fun because so many cultures coming together and, you know, having food or doing board games or having those great deeper conversations. Yeah. So that also feeds back to the Friday nights because people...
They're hungry for connection.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. People are coming from all the areas of our ministry to the Friday nights as well.
So we wish we could talk to you about our ministry all day because we could, but we want to talk to you about support raising.
Yes. So where are we at with support raising? Right now, our minimum monthly goal to be out here living and also doing all the ministry different areas here is 2,000 Canadian dollars a month. So we just got over 50% of that with our current supporters. Yes. And we're so excited, so thankful. We believe wholeheartedly that God wants us to be out here. And we know that He is going to provide, even if it hasn't been the easiest journey so far.
We want to talk to you about financial support.
Yes, so our list of close friends and those who we know to ask for support and to be on our financial support team is running short, but we know that God has a list of so many people who want to be involved in our ministry.
Yeah.
So that's not running short.
Don't hesitate to reach out on our social media platforms, and we're going to keep reaching out to as many people as we can in the church.
So if you know of anyone who would be interested in supporting a mission that seeks to sacrificially love young adults from all over the world.
Yeah, that connects with and serves those in need, including a great group of people, which is like homeless people in the city, women who have come out of prostitution, single parents we've been helping, students, those who have faced financial difficulties, especially with COVID, and so many more different people that we've met along the way. As well.
To encourage and challenge people to make intentional and purposeful decisions, especially those in the athletic world.
Yeah, that's our goal. And then the last thing we want to speak to you guys about is prayer. We believe in the power of prayer. We've said this countless times in our letters and even in our last video. And so far through prayer, we've seen God bring others to salvation. We've seen healing. We've seen barriers that hold back relationships broken. God has provided financially and He's brought big changes in atmospheres around us and so much more just through prayer. And so we want to partner with those who want to be informed about the most regular and frequent prayer needs, which is almost every week that we're sending out prayer requests to someone. Yeah.
This is not the last thing we're leaving with you. We've printed a bunch of cards, enough for everybody in the church, with our faces on them, and also some QR codes that you can scan to get to our social media, as well as our platform for support raising.
Yes. So please take one of those at the end of the service and put it on your fridge. Pray for us. And yeah, know that we're praying for you guys. We miss all of you at home, and we're looking forward to when we can come back and meet all of you again. And yeah, just catch up. So thanks, HCC. We'll be in touch soon.
Goodbye. Bye.